Hey party people, welcome to my channel. I'm Kitty, and if you're a returning viewer, you get a gold star today. Congratulations. I'm sorry if you hear a little buzzing. It's outside, so I can't do anything about it. Today we're going to be reacting to Trisha Paytas, some videos that they made over on one of their secret channels. Before we get started, don't forget to give me a like and subscribe to fight the TERFs, because they are still obsessed with me. Help an MB out. So I heard that Trisha Paytas has 720 YouTube channels, but I couldn't confirm that, so I don't know how true that is. But they do have at least a handful of secret channels, and the one we're going to be reacting to today is Trish Talks, I believe. And it has a decent amount of subscribers, but you know, nothing compared to their actual channel. I don't even know how to describe it other than cringy. Buckle in, it's gonna be fun. I did watch a couple of these videos yesterday because they were so funny, but this is a new one that I will be reacting to. And I said a decent amount of subscribers. I was thinking, like, I don't know why, I was thinking like 10K. Well, I forgot a zero. It's 130K. This video is called Gaslight, Gatekeep, Girl Boss, Ending Will Shock You, Trish Talks. I don't know if I'm ready because I've seen the other ones and, okay. Okay. Let's do it.
Excuse me. It says no smoking here.
It's a vape.
Why were they grooving with no music?
What? That's not a vape. It's a cigarette and it's gross.
Not as gross as the girl you're currently hooking up with. Did you know she has 3 transmittable diseases, 1 incurable? That's gross.
STI stigma. Not here for it.
Which girl?
T-Rex, the one with the short arms.
T-Rex. You're talking about Trace?
They also call her Big Fat Annoying Pig.
Well, how do you know that she has like transmittable diseases, 1 incurable?
I heard about it through a friend. Her only friend.
You're friends with her?
God no, I am not friends with her. If I was friends with her, I'd be going to her with this conversation.
Okay, as someone who rocked the yellow hair for a very long time, I just gotta say, I'm offended that she's using a yellow wig to portray this trashy. I'm just like, you know, you always hear people saying like, people with the funky hairs, they're trashy, and then here she is. Perpetuating that stigma, and I know that's stupid. I can be a little butthurt. It stings a little bit.
I am friends with you, Robbie, and I care about you as a friend and your health and safety. Look, I know you are 42 years old, and I'm just a 28-year-old that's not in a relationship with you, and I have no idea if you and T-Rex even had this conversation, but as your friend, I am looking out for you. I don't even know her. I don't even know if this is true. It's just what I heard.
Well, thanks. I appreciate it. Sorry I called you gross.
Ugh, it's okay. I'm the great garbanzo spectacle online. Everyone leaves me mean comments. The internet loves to gaslight me.
I don't know if this is just like part of the character or if she's actually throwing shade to the internet.
I know, there's so many haters there.
No, like the actual internet, like the servers, modems, data, apps, social media, like the programming is gaslighting me through the screens.
What? I had no idea that's even possible.
Well, I guess you could buy me a drink for that gaslighting.
Sure, you know, I appreciate you. That's the least I could do. Let's go.
Wait, when did he gaslight them? Why does he gotta buy them a drink? Because the internet's gaslighting them. I don't get it.
Welcome back to the Great Garbanzo Spectacle. Once again, I'm joined by my boring boyfriend. Baby, that's what all the comments are saying, is you're so boring.
What the fuck? What's going on?
I mean, I'm just quiet. I didn't even want to be here.
Oh my God, you like begged me to do this podcast.
Okay.
Wait, I thought, I'm confused because I thought they were just friends and he was dating a different girl that was girl. I'm so confused.
I Baby, tell a funny story.
What kind of a story?
I just said it, a funny one. God, do you even listen?
Let's see. Oh, you know, like during this crisis, we're like wearing masks and trying to be safe.
Oh my God, baby. Do you remember when you were hooking up with that trash bag last year that had like literally 16 incurable diseases?
I see what's going on. Okay, I get it. I wish the chickpeas would stop spinning in the background though, because it's like hurting my eyes.
It's like, ew, that was so gross. People ask me all the time, like, how are you even dating him? It was so gross. Like,
trash bags.
Trash bag, dumpster fire, T-Rex. Oh yeah, like we used to be best friends and then she became like weirdly obsessed with me.
What? I thought you weren't friends. Like, that was the whole reason you came to me about those rumors and stuff, don't you remember?
Okay, like, I can't even think right now, but like, that so didn't happen.
We need to cut this.
So the person talking about all the gaslighting is gaslighting.
Okay, we are never filming together again. Like, you begged me to do this podcast. Like,
I didn't beg you. You told me your guest canceled. I was just helping.
Why are you gaslighting me right now? I can't deal with this. I need a cigarette. Where's my actual lighter?
What? They made a gun noise for the lighter. Are you for real? For real. Also, like, why wouldn't you just edit in sound effects instead of making them with your mouth? It's not like you can't edit that in, cause like they got hella money. I hate to tell you all this, but their acting has improved. The boyfriend's still very bad. Husband? Boyfriend? I don't know. Still very bad. But Trisha's acting has improved. It's still bad, but you should see the old ones. They're horrible.
What are you doing? There's like a global crisis right now. Do you want to destroy everyone's lungs on top of that?
You're being such a square.
No.
Smoking kills. It's a fact.
And so did you on that podcast. Like, how could you even bring up your ex-girlfriend? Like, that's such a trigger for me.
You can smoke if you want, but not next to me. I'm done.
Baby, I'll stop. Look, I stopped. Okay.
Thanks. Do you want to finish the podcast?
No, you already ruined the vibe, my guy. I'll just do it later by myself.
Silent sneer. Why?
I am so done with this.
Can we talk about this?
I need a therapist? You need a therapist. You're a narcissistic abuser.
Why are we being so mean right now?
First the internet's gaslighting me, now you're trying to trigger me on purpose.
Why would I do that? I love you.
No, you only love trash bags.
What?
You only love trash bags. And they love you.
I think you gave me that one incurable disease, Robbie. So no, I am not going to therapist. I'm going to a gynecologist.
Well, let me go with you then.
They spelled it wrong. No! Y'all got too much time, too much money, and you're too damn old. This spelled gynecologist wrong on a video.
No, if you do that, I am driving off a cliff.
What the f***? Okay, I know it's supposed to be like, what the f***? And we're not supposed to like them, but like, what the f***?
There's no gas in the car. At least let me go fill up the gas in the car, okay?
I can fill out my own gas with my own money, Robbie. You're a narcissist, you're an abuser, and you're a misogynist. I'm going without you.
I'm just trying to help.
Confused rejection. Me. Grooving again. There's music this time, though, at least. Okay, American Spirits. Green Box. I've never seen that one.
Heck yeah! I'm trending on TweetTweet.
TweetTweet. That was the name you're gonna come up for your fake Twitter. TweetTweet. Trending on TweetTweet. Hey, what's up? You got a TweetTweet? You got a TweetTweet? What's your TweetTweet?
People try to gaslight me, but I always win. Yeah! I deserve you. Wait, I should go live before I light up and show them what I'm all about.
At least I got a real cigarette this time.
Out. Hey guys, what's up?
Why?
Oh wow, thanks Paul.
That was some really great editing and some really good acting.
This movie is gonna be so much fun. No, you can tell him I don't even want to get paid. It's fine. Well, okay, fine. If he has to, just tell him to donate it to the national organization for my home country, okay? Just make it a big donation, give it to them. Yeah, this is so cool. Thanks, Paul. Well, wait, one second.
Ding!
Ding! Trisha, I'm tired of this.
Yeah, this is Robbie Hart. What? She's on fire? She was on fire? Where is she? Is she okay?
She's on fire.
I want to come and see her. Do you know where she is? Oh wait, I see her right now. She's coming here. Thanks. Oh my God, sweetie, are you okay?
I'm just a little sore. I'm just glad nothing more serious happened. I don't know how to pump gas. A little just got on my finger and then...
It's fine.
I'm so sorry, Robbie. I shouldn't have been smoking cigarettes. They do kill.
Oh my God, cigarettes was butchered on the captions. Butchered.
In more ways than one.
You gotta expect the unexpected.
I'm gonna call Tracy and apologize right now for gaslighting her.
Well, it's a good idea, but maybe not right now. Maybe we should try and go to like couples therapy, talk to someone. I think it's important we learn what gaslighting actually means, that we know when we're doing it or somebody's doing it to us.
I think you're right. Thanks for still being here. Everybody leaves me.
Let's keep that for tomorrow, okay? You should tell that to the therapist.
That was manipulation.
I love you. I won't leave you. Your fans love you. There's so many people that love you. They're not out there to get you.
I guess with a name like Garbanzo, you just assume everyone hates you. Sometimes I think I'm named after that annoying little blue Muppet.
That's actually exactly what I thought of when they said Garbanzo. I didn't think of chickpeas. I thought of... Well, I thought of the Muppet in the dress. I was thinking of Gonzarella. And how mad Prager you got. Prager you. Oh my God, the 15-minute video about a 10-second clip. I'll never forget it.
I'm not sure what you're named after, but Garbanzo, that's like the most important ingredient of my beloved hummus.
Hummus.
Oh, still a little sore.
Be careful. I got good news. Paul just called. I'm gonna be in a movie.
Wow, your best day happens on my worst day.
What do you say? Let's call Dr. Pepper.
Not Dr. Pepper!
I love you, and I can't see you keep doing this.
Doing what?
I don't know. I'm not a professional. I don't want to misdiagnose you or use the wrong terminology. Let's just go to the therapist and see what he says.
Okay, that's responsible of you.
I love you, baby. You're my favorite little hummus ingredient.
And you're my favorite movie star.
Oh.
My favorite little hummus ingredient. Okay, so as you can see, that was terrible. Everything about it was terrible. I mean, the first two were really bad, but this one, there's no way this can't be satire. Like, this has to be satirical, right? Please.
Gaslighting is manipulative, and I could give you the definition of manipulation, but there are literally so many. Let's not misuse or misdiagnose terms like gaslighting and narcissist.
Are they only doing this because the internet comes at them for doing this shit?
They hold serious weight. Being undiagnosed or over-diagnosing someone online or in real life is very dangerous.
Being undiagnosed online? What?
Everyone deserves love. Everyone deserves life. Say no to cigarettes and yes to therapists.
Cigarettes is still butchered. Say no to cigarettes and yes to therapists.
Don't go live when pumping gas and never ever put an open flame near gasoline. You deserve life, and we here at Church Talk want to see you live. Mental health is no joke. Get treated, medicated, talk to someone. There's no shame in that.
So I can't decide if it is satire because like, at the end of every single one, they're like, give this nice positive message, but that was really fucking weird. Everything about that was weird. It wasn't even like a positive message. It was just like, if people on the internet use words and they don't really know what they mean, which a lot of people say that, and I honestly just like, whatever, I don't care. I don't know. I'm not out here to be like, you're wrong about the thing that you said is manipulation, or you're wrong about the thing that you said is gaslighting. Unless, like, I know for sure that they're wrong, I'm not gonna, like, be like, you don't even know what that means. Because maybe they do. Maybe they do know what it means. You know what I mean? Okay, wait, I have an addendum. I don't know if that's the right word. Just found out that apparently that video that I just reacted to was Trisha coming for Gabby Hanna. I don't know, that's funny. So it is satire. Okay, I was right. I thought so, but I've seen a lot of people, well, not a lot of people, but there's a few people talking about their channel, like talking about how bad it is, because it is bad, but it's also satire, so I'm glad I was right there. But the shade to Gabby, the whole message was very weird, and I still don't know if they're trying to be serious or not. But the acting is horrible, the editing is horrible, and even the message was horrible. I really just feel like it's clickbait, maybe, but even then, I don't know. Honestly, who knows what's going on with Trisha? It's funny because like they're talking about how people don't know what gaslighting means, but I feel like they're throwing shade at the people who called them a gaslighter and called them manipulative, because they've definitely done that to other people, and for some reason they still have a huge platform, and I don't get it. I mean, it seems like that, well, it did seem like they were trying to actually improve and work on themselves. Honestly, I don't know anymore. I really don't. I hope you enjoyed watching Trish Talks with Me. Let me know if you want to watch more of those, because I'm sure they're going to keep posting them. I know it wasn't necessarily LGBTQ+ related, but Trisha is non-binary, so like it counts, right? If you made it all the way here, comment down below. Well, I didn't think of what I was going to end the sentence with. Imara's going crazy right now. Hi. If you made it all the way here, comment your favorite food down below. I don't know, I was gone for 2 weeks, not intentionally. We had some major technical difficulties and they have finally been figured out. Oh my God, Imara, you're making so much noise! So I was gone for a couple weeks. The YouTube algorithm like punishes you if you're gone that long. So I need your help. Give me a like, comment down below. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you next time.